For me, equity of opportunity for everybody is a principle that is extremely important to me. Another principle is thinking about things instead of just reacting out of what would be a normal cultural tendency, because we're all products of our culture, and that can mean that we can act and react in ways that are really not helpful to other people or to ourselves. So I think it's important to always question what is true or what is right and really think about it. When I joined Texas Instruments in 1966, in the first 2 years I was there, I met two other women in exempt positions. By the time I left, and I'm happy to have been part of the change because I led the diversity effort for TI for many, many years. When I left, 27% of the officers at TI were women, 40% of the board members, and this is in a company that is an engineering company where still today only 20% of engineering graduates are women. So it was a remarkable change, and I'm proud to have been part of it.
What makes you feel most alive?
For me, I think I feel the best when I have something to do with positive change. And that can be positive change for a friend. It can be positive change for the world. It can be positive change, in business. Just when you know that you're doing something that's going to have a better result for lots of things.
At which age so far have you enjoyed the most, and why?
I keep enjoying every age. I'll have to say, being part of the women's movement in the 1970s was probably one of the most fun things because I learned the most. I was part of seeing more things change, and I just felt very involved in the excitement of all of that. I've had people say to me, gosh, it must have been terrible. And in fact, there were lots of situations for women that were very terrible and absolutely had to be changed. But it was exciting to be a part of that change and to learn to think differently. And, being involved in that sort of thing is fun.
And now, you look at Harvard has been around for 371 years, and they just elected their first female president, Drew Faust. And then, I can't remember the college, but Annette Simmons mm-hmm. is the first African-American female president of an Ivy League university. Now that you're starting...
Smith.
Is it Smith? Is it mm-hmm. Annette Smith? Is
it? No, it's...
Smith University?
Right.
Okay.
And she's on the board of Texas Instruments. Hello.
So how does that make you feel? It's starting to really come around. I mean, you had your time, you had now, and you see the old pictures of the women in the bonnets, let us vote. And now you see it. I mean, how does that make you feel?
Makes me feel terrific. The interesting part is, if you had told me in 1971, when I first got involved with women's issues, that I would still be working on them 40 years later, I wouldn't have believed you. Because I really thought that when people thought about the fact that, the way the world had changed, that women could participate equally in whatever they felt they wanted to. What would the barriers be? When I thought about that for myself, and when the whole feminist movement started, I just assumed people would think about it and get the fact that it made sense for women to participate equally, and we'd move on. So the exciting part is, 40 years later, we're seeing some change. The amazing part is, it's taken 40 years. So I've come to a place where I've really understood the power of culture and the cultural messages that are so ingrained in our society and around the world and what it really takes to make a difference.